It's showtime.
Hey, welcome to Did You Watch Survivor Last Night? This is the only Survivor podcast, so don't even try listening to another one. My name is Jake Scheidel. This is a podcast where each week I ask my best friend if he did watch a certain reality show. Hey, Thomas, how are you doing today?
Jake, you know what? You've been doing this. This is the first time in a long time that you've slipped up during the intro, so
what?
I'm gonna give you a pass.
I did it perfectly. What are you talking about?
You had to hesitate for a minute there because you forgot what you're supposed to say.
Well, Thomas, in my defense, I was reading it off of paper, and I, you know, don't know how to read. So
you do have problems with that.
If I haven't memorized it, then I'm not going to be able to do it, and I haven't memorized it in the 5 years we've been doing this podcast. So,
yep.
You know, you can't blame me for trying.
You certainly can't. Jake.
Yes.
Father's Day today.
It is Father's Day
today. I want to wish a happy Father's Day to Tom Scheidel.
It's my dad.
That's Jake's dad.
Yep.
I want to wish a very happy Father's Day, and I will be doing it in person today. Mm-hmm. But I want to wish a very happy Father's Day to Joseph Powell.
That's your dad.
My father.
Well, I would like to take this moment to wish a very happy Father's Day to my father, Thomas Scheidel, as well as your father, Joseph Powell, and as well.
Oh, thank you. I was going to get really mad if you didn't wish it to my dad, because I did it to yours, so I appreciate that you did.
And also my grandfather, his name is also Thomas Scheidel, so.
All right, well, now you're just trying to upstage me.
It's Father's Day, you know, show some respect. Look, this month is all about dads and grads, and there's nothing else prioritizing.
It is about dads and grads, and I appreciate that you brought that up.
It's all about dads and grads. That's what we're going to remember June as forever. Dads and grads. What is it, the third Sunday of June?
How many open houses are you going to? How many open houses are you going to, Jake? That time of year, baby.
Oh, man. Probably zero, I think. I'm more likely to go to an open house I find on Redfin at this point than high schoolers. Oh. 'Cause I'm an adult now. I feel very adult. I read a New York Times article last night about the children and literally had the sentence run through my brain. There's an alt TikTok? So that made me feel very old.
Yeah, we are getting old. The Zoomers are trying to own us, and they're right to do it in a lot of respects, speaking of being adults.
Well, because the millennials, they
making
are
fun of making fun of the term adulting, like, yeah, we deserve that.
That's right.
But the thing is, like, they're starting to branch out into stuff that, like, isn't really true about millennials instead of focusing on the stuff that we, like, the crimes that we really need to answer for, like, all humor from, like, 2010 to 2012. Like, there's a lot we have to answer for, and instead they're like, oh, I love millennials, be like, I love Hillary Clinton. It's like, that's not, we do not be like that.
But in millennials' defense, Hillary Clinton did want us to Pokemon Go to the polls. So
that's true, she did.
Like, well, I don't know what the Zoomers are talking about, because they weren't old enough to Pokemon Go to the polls in 2016. That's not our fault.
Yeah.
Okay, Zoomers?
I did feel... And honestly, like, the adulting thing just stems from us all being really poor for a long time, so, like, anything that we get to do that makes us feel like we were supposed to at this age, it's like, wow, damn, crazy. I'm like a tourist of being an adult.
Yeah. Yeah.
But you know what? I'm starting to live that life permanently. Last week I talked about how I did a bunch of spring cleaning.
Mm-hmm.
The dresser that I ordered
beautiful dresser.
I love it, and, it took me about 5 hours to assemble it, but I did it, and man, real sense of accomplishment when you do something like that.
Mm-hmm. I am very excited to replace the furniture in my home. You very much inspired me with that dresser, Thomas, and I'm just excited to like really go into adulthood, which Zoomers don't understand. They don't know the first thing about adulting. They're like, we're barely teenagers. Get out of here.
Yeah, come on now. I did appreciate that someone was like, look, you're right to own us on the Harry Potter stuff, but if you're going to make fun of us for being alcoholics and poor, like, I've got bad news for you about what the next 5 to 10 years hold for you.
Welcome to your 20s.
Yeah, it's like, it's going to be you.
Yeah. That's not a millennial thing.
Yeah.
That's As just always, an adulting the thing.
It's very much an adulting thing. As always, the ultimate... summation, I think The Simpsons, you can point to for a lot of this stuff. But the Grandpa Simpson thing where he says, you know, like, I used to be with it, but then they changed what it was.
Yeah.
Now I'm not what's it, and what is it is weird and scary to me. And then he points at Homer and goes, it'll happen to you.
Yeah, it's just, it's weird to watch, like, media that I have consumed as a teenager and relating to characters that I did not relate to when I was like 17 years old.
Absolutely, man. I'm watching Avatar: The Last Airbender.
Yeah, I was gonna ask you about that.
I mean, I always liked Iroh, but like, man, Iroh, best character.
Great dude.
On that show.
Great dude. Really, better than Appa?
Well, yeah, okay.
Better than Momo?
Maybe not better than Appa.
Better than Toph?
I like Toph, but
who doesn't like Toph? Toph's great. They're all great. Thomas, speaking of Zoomers and Millennials, how soon do you think it'll be before Survivor does Zoomers versus Millennials?
Oh, man. That's going to be great because we're going to get to be like pandered to in the way that the Gen X tribe was pandered to by
Jeff
Probst.
Gonna be beautiful.
Like, remember how annoyed we were at, like, Jeff being like, these millennials probably want their participation trophy, huh?
Yeah. Who's the millennial Jeff Probst? Adam Ruins Everything?
Yeah, maybe. I don't know. Yeah, who else would it be?
I'll tell you who it's not.
Isn't, who's the guy that was hosting, Are You the One, initially?
Ryan Devlin?
Ryan Devlin is definitely a millennial, right?
Ryan Devlin. Devlin age. Man, I miss him. I miss Are You the One entirely. It's been so long. Ryan Devlin age. Okay. He can't be 40 yet. 41. Okay, so, nope, he is on the tail end of Gen X.
That is Gen X? Okay.
He was born in 79. Just missed the cut. You know who? Ooh.
Well, I wanted to say him, but now I can't.
Can't say him. Okay.
And I think TJ is also Gen X.
Yeah, I think TJ is a little bit older than Ryan Devlin. I can't believe Ryan Devlin is 41. That's wild.
Crazy.
I would have assumed he was a couple years older than us. Okay. You know who it should be?
Who?
Corey Wharton from The Challenge.
Wow, okay.
Corey Wharton should take over for Jeff Probst. I would watch it. But unfortunately, Jeff Probst did host this current season we're watching. Thomas, did you watch Survivor, San Juan Del Survivor last night?
I certainly did.
This week's episode was called Actions versus Accusations. I think a good episode title because I tripped up over it. I love alliteration, except for when I can't read. Good episode title, even though it was a line from John Rocker. It was still good, I think. Josh aligns with John Rocker. I didn't love that. I didn't love those two getting together. Drew naps while everyone works on the camp, and Nat calls him out on it. This was a fun scene. I love seeing Drew get shit on. Not a lot happened in this episode, I'm realizing, looking at my notes.
Yeah. No, I really liked Jeremy talking about him and being like, I want to take him to the end because he's not going to win, but like, I don't even think he's going to, like, I think he's going to quit before I can even get him there.
We get to the loved ones duel. Jeremy sees that Val is gone and tells the women on Coyopa to get together and start voting out the men. Rocker then admits in front of everyone that he was working with Val, which was a weird move for him to do. I didn't realize that was a secret.
Yeah, I mean, like, I would maybe wait. Like, he mentions later in the episode, he's like, well, if Jeremy and I make it to the merge, like, I'll explain what happened. Because, like, honestly, he wasn't in the wrong there. Like, Val fucked up. It wasn't his fault.
Yeah.
He
could have done more,
but I think he was trying to repair the Jeremy thing a little too soon.
Yeah. It's just, I don't know. I don't think John Rocker's a very good Survivor player.
No, I don't either, but, you know.
Wes goes against Keith in the duel. They have to carry some metal squares across a balance beam.
Absolutely wonderful, this whole thing was. I love this challenge. I love the father-son relationship between them. I thought the end was really nice. man, I just love Keith being on the show. It's the best.
Yeah, there's a reason he was on Second Chances. I think Keith needs to come back for Survivor Third Time's a Charm. But, you know, Jeff still hasn't contacted me about producing, probably because I am starting a petition to get him fired so Corey Wharton can start hosting Survivor.
Of course, yeah. Jake, what was this challenge called?
You know what? I have not been keeping track of the Loved Ones Duels challenges names because they don't, like, they haven't really shown up elsewhere. Why do you ask?
I liked the challenge, so I was curious what it was called.
Yeah, I don't think it's been done before.
Man, I also just having the loved ones square off every episode is great.
Mm-hmm.
Like, it's just great.
Yeah, and unfortunately, eventually the loved ones do start disappearing. So like, it's less exciting. I don't know.
What are they like, Mr. Probst? I don't feel so good, and then they disintegrate.
Yeah, like in Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Okay, what?
Like, in when Spider-Man, and I cried when that happened, because I thought he was dead. Because I'm an idiot.
I'm a dumb person who doesn't understand how contracts work.
I'm a stupid child, and I don't understand that they're not going to kill off Spider-Man right when they made a movie franchise.
Okay, Thomas, I'll have you know, this quote-unquote hero duel, which is what they're apparently called, the Sunset Authority is in charge of this challenge because it is called Sunset Grill.
Oh, boy.
It's...
Why is it called that?
I could not tell you. Because the... I don't know. I've never been to a Sunset Grill. Isn't that a place? A restaurant?
Is it?
I don't know. I would Google it, but I don't care that much.
I've never heard of that.
Well, that's what they called it, so you're going to have to ask Jeff Probst or Corey when he takes over and they redo this season. Wes wins, so Keith has to go to Exile Island again and is sent there with Josh. And then over at the Hunapu tribe, Jeremy tells everybody who Jen Rocker is. Great scene. Would love to watch it over and over again. Then at Exile, Keith and Josh eat snails. That's fun. How do you feel like snails taste?
Yeah. Good good Josh episode, by the way. I honestly, like, I like to focus on Josh. I like him a lot as a player.
Mm-hmm.
I enjoyed it. I thought it was nice.
I'll have you know, there's not a lot of bad Josh episodes.
Yeah, no, I'm not surprised to hear that. Like, this was the episode where I really was like, oh, I think he's one of my favorite people on the season.
Yeah, he's great. It's so fun to, like, watch a season over and over again and, like, really delve into the arc of certain characters and see how they, like, develop. Because I'll have you know, I don't think this is much of a spoiler, Josh makes it a good distance.
Yeah, I'm not surprised to hear that at all.
And it's just, you know, the people he goes up against in his fights are... There's a lot behind it, and it's very interesting to see where everybody aligns throughout the season. I don't know. Survivor's an interesting show. We should do a podcast about it.
Yeah.
I don't know why more people don't do podcasts about Survivor. It's such a good show. There is only one, and it's this one, and it's the best one. Over at Coyopa, John Rocker catches fish, and then Baylor targets John Rocker. Again, not a lot happens. But then we get to the immunity challenge, which is a very good immunity challenge. They do basketball through an obstacle course, and it's very good.
Yeah, as anyone where people are shooting into a basket, like, it's going to be what I like.
It's just shooting hoops. This is the only time this specific challenge has ever been done. And it's got a great name, Thomas. Can you guess what the name is? I'll give you two hints. One, it's a pun. Two, it's a pop culture reference. It's a pun on a pop culture reference.
Boy, I just tell me.
Okay. It's called Game of Throw-ins. It's good, right?
That's pretty good.
So Hunapu wins Game of Throw-ins. I don't know why they haven't brought this challenge back. It's the perfect challenge with a perfect name. Natalie and Rocker get in a fight, and Koyopa defends him, and then he says he knocked Natalie's teeth out. So, cool guy. Love this guy.
Yeah, that was... I got that spoiled for me when I was reading about John Rocker, like when I checked his Wikipedia to see his old comments, and I was like, oh boy.
Yeah.
Got that to look forward to.
What a miserable dude.
He's got a really bad temper. Like, I think that's what it comes down to.
No, hey, no, those are fighting words. To say he has a bad temper, those are fighting words.
Oh, right, okay.
Okay. And also, he's not a racist or a bigot or a homophobe.
He's not good. Yeah, he
did you like...
There's no real interest... There's not a lot of introspection there, and then also he immediately gets defensive the minute that, like, anybody calls him out, which is not a good combination.
Well, I mean, in John Rocker's defense, did you like when he said that he can't be homophobic because his closest ally is a gay guy?
Yeah, of course.
Yeah. I like that Rudy, in the year 2000, was more accepting of his gay ally than John Rocker.
Yeah.
It's cool. Cool guy.
I think there is something to be said about being like, well, like, you know, obviously, I think you need to not be saying homophobic things, and that's a very low baseline and important thing not to do, but also, like, how you act around people is also very important. And, like, I think if he just, like, the thing that he needed to do was just say, like, I'm trying to prove with my actions who I am as a person. I'm trying to move past previous remarks. I was immature. I regret saying them.
Mm-hmm.
And, like, I know that I can only really, like, show that I've changed. Like, I have to prove it, basically. I can't just say that I've changed.
Right.
But the way that you do that is not by being like, see? I didn't say homophobic shit to Josh, so clearly I'm good now.
Oh, my God. I'm one of the good ones.
Like, you can't be like demanding that people give you credit for it, basically.
Yeah. Baylor thinks she's the next to go.
What about all the times I wasn't racist?
Yeah.
People aren't giving me credit for that.
I'm not racist like 89% of the time.
Yeah. Nobody, you won't hear about that though.
It's like a solid B plus.
Yeah, come on.
Look, we're all trying. John Rocker then targets Dale, but is secretly planning to vote for Baylor. John Rocker then tells Josh about his idol, so Josh goes and convinces Baylor and Wes to vote for John Rocker. It's good. I love to see John Rocker get shit on. It's very funny. I just don't like... That's all.
No, you shouldn't.
Before we talk about who gets voted out, who could it possibly be? We have to talk about these wildlife shots. Alive. We are in a new country for Survivor. It is Nicaragua. So we've got some new wildlife shots. We've got vultures, we've got monkeys, we've got birds, we've got snakes, we've got spiders. We got a spectacled caiman. How do you feel about caimans, Thomas? I feel like they're the forgotten crocodilian.
I couldn't agree more. With what you just said.
Which was?
That they're the forgotten crocodilian or whatever the fuck you just said.
Yep.
Yeah, I totally agree.
They're also known as the white caiman, the common caiman.
Very underrated. I feel like they're having a moment right now.
Also known as the speckled caiman. They're green, yellow, brownish, small to medium crocodilian. They grow to be 3.5 to 8 feet long. They're called the spectacled caiman because there is a ridge between their eyes that looks like a pair of spectacles, which is a very fun fact. They eat crabs and snails and fish and small mammals. Here is the most fun fact about the spectacled caiman, even more fun than their natural glasses. The sex of the babies is dependent upon the temperature of the nest the eggs are laid in. Isn't that interesting?
Oh, okay.
It's something like if it's more than 90 degrees, the eggs will hatch female larvae or whatever they're called. And if it's less, then it's male. I don't know. I'm not a scientist. I can barely read. At Tribal Council, Baylor gets 2 votes and everybody else votes for John Rocker. I don't think there's anything more that needs to be said about that.
No, I thought it was a nice tense Tribal Council because they kept cutting to, John reacting to people saying stuff and you just keep being like, is he going to play his idol?
Did you think he was going to play his idol?
No, I didn't. I thought they were going to get him, but there were a couple minutes where I was like, you better stop talking or you're going to spook him.
Yeah, I was very happy to see him go.
I thought Josh played that perfectly. Mm-hmm. Absolutely perfectly.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Because Josh, you could tell as it was happening, John was very surprised.
I'm surprised Josh hasn't come back. I guess he's probably busy because he's like on Broadway, but
yeah,
I imagine that's probably a pretty busy schedule. But yeah, he should come back. He and Reed should both come back. And Wes. And a lot of this cast, honestly. Good cast.
Yeah, it's a good season.
Thomas, did you watch the challenge Total Madness last night?
I sure didn't.
Man, it's like you're not even supporting the future hosts of Survivor.
No, I'm not supporting. So Corey's on this season, I take it.
Corey is on this season, yes. This week's challenge was one of those where they just have to move a bunch of metal from one location to another. Bailey, Fessy, and D win. Then Corey gets the house to vote him into elimination. The tribunal then nominates Josh, Swaggy, C, and Kyle because they're the only men without red skulls. And then here was the best moment of this season. While Corey's getting inspired for his eliminations, he's looking at pictures of his daughter, Ryder. Remember Ryder, Thomas?
Yes. Yes, I do. The product of Team Princess.
Yes. Well, no. Team Princess was... wasn't that Cheyenne and Devin?
Oh, yeah. I guess so. Never mind. But him and Cheyenne, yeah.
Yeah, yeah.
Is Devin still on the show? Has he been back?
He hasn't been on in quite a few seasons, unfortunately.
Man, that's a bummer.
Yeah. He'll probably be back soon enough. I think people are ready for him to come back, or at least he's ready. Whatever, who cares? Dumb show. Why are you asking? You don't even watch this show.
Yeah, it's true. I guess I don't. It's not going to affect me either way.
Would you start watching if Devin was on this show?
Probably not, but it would make me more likely to watch it.
Fair enough. What if Devin took over for Jeff Probst, millennial?
Yeah,
Jeff,
sure.
Probst. I think that'd be good.
Why not?
He's a smart guy. He's charming. Like a radio, a television host. Okay. Anyway, Corey's looking at pictures of Ryder, and it's very funny because they are playing the song "The Kids Aren't All Right" by The Offspring.
No, no.
And it's supposed to be like this really inspirational scene.
It would be really funny if they were playing "My Ambitions as a Ryder" by Tupac.
It's great. Swaggy C gets voted into elimination, where they have to swing on the sides of a shipping container and turn on 20 lights. It's fine. It's like fine, whatever. There's better eliminations. Corey wins and is now eligible to run the final. So, feeling pretty good about that. Are you excited to see Corey, who's from our hometown? We basically went to school with him.
It's true, yeah. He's in the house. That's what I've been told.
He is in the house, and he will remain in the house for a while. I don't know. The season's probably almost over. That's the thing about the challenge. It can be anywhere from 13 to 24 episodes a season, and they never tell you beforehand. It's a great show. Next week, we're watching the fourth episode of San Juan Del Survivor. It's called We're a Hot Mess, Thomas. We're a hot mess. What are your initial thoughts on that episode title? What are you expecting?
Man, probably one of the tribes is going to be dysfunctional.
Yeah, true. Indeed. Any guesses on what tribe will be the dysfunctional one?
Probably what are the tribe names again? I know the one with the like yellow buffs or whatever is probably,
yeah, there's the orange
one.
Tribe, who is the one that keeps losing. That was the one with John Rocker.
Yeah, it's
that's
probably
Koyopa.
I would guess it's them,
and the other
losing
one is Hunapu.
Yeah, Koyopa,
that's the one
definitely
with
they
Natalie
losing
and Jeremy. Great season, great tribes, great cast. Can't wait to watch this episode again. Follow us on Twitter at DYWSLN. You can follow me at Jake Shadell, because that's my name.
Follow me at Tom Not Tom.
You can review us on Apple Podcasts. It is a 5-star only platform. They actually disallowed anybody to give a lower rating. So
yeah, you aren't allowed to give us a lower rating than 5 stars.
We actually talked to Apple specifically for our podcast.
Yeah, Tim Apple said that.
Yeah. Tim Apple. Oh, great stuff. What a good day it is in the neighborhood. I've been saying in the neighborhood a lot recently. And I don't know why. Anyway.
You ever think about if they made a shirt that had Mr. Rogers on it and it said, "It's all good in the hood"?
Oh, that's really funny.
Yeah. I just think that would be pretty funny.
Go to a website and make that t-shirt and we can sell it as merch for the Mr. Rogers show that we're also going to do for Patreon. Mr. Rogers is a good dude. I like him.
That's our most controversial opinion yet.
Hot take. Likeable guy. Mr. Rogers. The Rock's middle name is Roger. No, Douglas, sorry. Anyway.
I don't know. What does that have to do with anything?
Nothing. Anyway. Have a great summer.
Yeah, we'll leave you with that.
Have a great quarantine.
Yeah, deuces.
Okay. Give blood, but you may find the blood is not enough.